I want to introduce the speaker on the hour for those who may not know, those that are watching first time. I want to introduce a man that has a strong bond with the Lord. A man that has been through many things. But his life today is an evidence that the devil can't beat you when God is your leader. He's a man that is dedicated to the ministry. He's a man that's been preaching 20 years. He's a man that no matter what, he doesn't compromise with the devil. That he's only going to give you what God's spoken word has given unto him. There's nothing else I can say to you if I talk about where he went to school and that, but the only school you need to know is that the Holy Ghost took him through. See, as an elementary child, he was first born and gave his life to Christ. As a middle schooler, he learned the word of God and how to divide and speak the truth. As a high schooler, he told the devil that you can try me, but you won't take me down. As a college student, he told the devil that if you let me get past you, I'll run forever for the Lord. And now that with a master's degree, he is now a profound leader of Living Word Church.
Amen.
So I don't need to go through too much, but what I will tell you that don't try to focus on the natural, but listen in the spirit. I can tell you that he don't mind singing and he don't mind preaching. If you make him real happy, he'll dance for you too. One thing about him, the word, they said the truth will hurt, but it's the truth that comes from this pulpit. So I want to introduce and present to some the one and only dynamic man of God, Bishop David E. Tompkins, Sr., who will come and bring you the word. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. And the Boyd brothers come and present us with a selection before then. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, let's give the twins a hand clap of praise. Amen. They walk alike, talk alike, act alike.
They sure do.
Amen. Both of them preaching.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. What's in you? How many know what's in you comes out?
Yes.
Give them another hand clap of praise.
Praise God, everybody. Praise God. I tell you, God is so good. Let's give a wonderful clap of praise. Again, a wonderful, awesome designer of Living Word. We thank and praise God. I thank God for my family here today.
Amen.
They so surprised me today, everyone.
Amen.
I know y'all was kind of messed up this morning. I know some of y'all don't know I have a twin, ain't you? Yeah, I thank God for me and my brother being together this morning. It's such a blessing.
Amen.
To have someone that is just like you. You see what I'm saying? It's just like you, and God is in you. I thank God for that. We're going to do a song, a nice, sweet song, me and my brothers to sing together. And hope you guys enjoy it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Here's another thing.
had so many dark days, but I'm still here. Oh yeah, could sleep at night. Oh yeah, cry days. I had so many lonely nights, but I'm still here.
I'm still here.
By the grace of God, disappointments. I had so many disappointments, but I'm still here. Through it all, another day turned in. God kept me here. Have you kept me through the years? Have you brought you over? I made it through another day turned in. God kept me here. I've been talking about you now, but I did. I made it through another day.
Oh Lord, disappointment. I see myself disappointed. Oh Lord,
but I'm still here.
Oh Lord, disappointment. I see myself disappointed.
Oh yeah, but I'm still here. Through it all. Yes, I made it. God kept me here. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I made it.
Oh,
yes, I made it. I'm still here. I'm still here. Oh, I made it. Yes, I made it. Yeah. It's gone in 2018, but I am. I made it. Oh, I made it. We made it. We still here. Been times when we found ourselves by ourselves, but we made it.
The promise of the sleep,
we made it.
Still covered with tears,
I'm still here.
While you win, trouble will end.
Oh yeah,
trouble don't last always.
I made it.
Look at you wander,
yes,
and trembling, oh Lord. Trouble don't last always.
Don't last always. Thank you, friends. Amen. Father, in God now, if it pleases you now, go with it as we come to this altar now, as we come to this place of reverence now, asking you to please have mercy upon every person in this building, God. We come calling upon our Father's name and knowing that there is power above power. Father God, I ask you now if you let your healing blessings to walk through this building this morning, God. You let your Shekinah glory come here. God, and bless every person here now, God. Bless this, your word, God, as you can only do, God. And God, I ask you now if you would please decrease this servant, God, and you would please increase in him, because I believe somebody need a word, God. Let your word transfer, God, from heart to heart in this building, God, that everything will be all right, God. God, bless every preacher here now, God. Bless every amen here, God. Bless every open moment here. And God, we just thank you now for what you're getting ready to do now. In Jesus' name we pray. Let everybody shout hallelujah. It is so. I give reference to each of you in the power of the Holy One, to all our visitors, and to each of you in your place that you are, that God will see you through even right now. I just believe just one call will make through for you, will make day for you, will make hay for you, God, and will make everything all right. I don't know about you, but you ought to just try him one more time and let everything be all right. And he will make a way out of no way and show up when you think not. Somebody will say, show up Jesus for me. Show up Jesus for me. To all of our ministers in their prospective places, and to all our church leaders, and we say now that God is alive in this place. God is alive in this house. All you got to do is learn how to trust him.
Yes.
You can't trust a name that you can't call upon. Now, if you're able to call upon him, you ought to be able to trust him.
Yes.
And knowing that everything will be all right. And that's in Jesus' name.
Yes.
God is just good. All by himself. Hallelujah. As we continue to pray for Sister Diane, who lost her mother. Her mother was here visiting with us a little long ago, sat right over there. Her funeral will be today at 3 o'clock. And those of you that are able to go down to Pastor Rice's church, I want some of us to go. Amen. If you're going, let me know that you may take an offering for the maidens. Let me know you're going, and we will give you an offering. Amen.
Amen.
Because God is just good. All the time. And all the time, God is good. Let's go to Genesis, the 39th chapter of our text for the day, and see what the word has for the house. When I needed him the most, I say when I needed him the most, Jesus was right there by my side. Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
God is just good. Let's read from the first verse down through the sixth verses of that text, if you will, please.
And Joseph was brought down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, brought him out of the hands into Ishmaelite, which had brought him down thither. And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of the master of the Egyptians.
Mm-hmm.
And his master saw the Lord was with him, and said that the Lord made all that he did to prosper mm-hmm. in his hands.
Uh-huh.
And Joseph found grace in the sight, and he served him, and he made him overseer over his house, and all that he had he put into his hands. And it came to pass from that time that he had made him overseer in the house and over all his land. And the Lord blessed the Egyptian house for Joseph's sake. And the blessing of the Lord was upon that he had in the house and in the field.
Mm-hmm.
And he left all that he had in Joseph's hand. And he knew not aught he had, save the bread for which he did eat.
Mm-hmm.
And Joseph was a goodly person and well-favored.
Now, certainly with the aid of the Holy Ghost, I want to talk about this message entitled, When the Lord is with You.
Yes.
People of God, let me tell you something. When you know that, you know that, you know, Elder Robinson, when the Lord is with you, no harm can be done to you. Oh, it may look frustrated. It may look like sometimes the enemy is going to try to take you out and take over. But when the Lord is with you, the enemy is not protected. I can't hear nobody. Listen, I don't care where you come from. I don't care what you're going through. But when the Lord is with you, everything is going to work out for your good. Now, somebody say for your good. This wasn't just a goodly person, but he was well favored. And when you're well favored, no hard work can come your way. It may look like it's coming to see you about to deceive you, but it can't attack you. It can't take you out. It may look like it wants the favor of God off of you, but it can't do anything against what God has already blessed. Tell somebody, you can't mess what God has already blessed. You can't mess up with God and all that favor on him. And you know God got favor on your life. You ought to be showing up praising his holy name. You ought not be standing in a position that you're not going to lose. But when you know you got favor, you're coming out. I don't care how sick you may be. I don't care how down you may be. I don't care how cast out you may be. But whatever you got favor on your life, it's got to work out for your good. When you have really have favor on your life. Yeah, what did the doctor say? No, I got favor.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord. Thank the people of God, before I dive into this message, it's time for you to bring yourself out. Everybody got something to say, but that something to say can't do me no good. Let me say that again. Everybody got something to say, but that something to say can't bring me out. Have mercy on him. Take your seat. When the Lord is with you, as we make ready to deal with this text, and as the Lord has given favor this morning, the Lord was with Joseph. When we look at this text, and when we know Joseph is our king of the message today, so to speak, and he had been betrayed by his own brothers and sold as a slave, the Bible says that Joseph had been sold to some Ishmaelites merchant for less than $100. His brother sold him for the price of a crippled slave. So every now and then the devil will do anything to take favor from you. The devil, only thing the devil wants to do for the whole time is to come against what you know. But when you know what you know, that you know, that you know. And a devil in hell can change what God has blessed you with. Okay? As long as you know that you know, that you know, that you know, that I am a child of God, saved, sanctified, set free, and running for my life, and I know I'm in the right place at the right time. And you don't worry about the enemy. You don't worry about what the enemy has to say. All you know is that God has favored my life. Can't spend no time worrying about this and that, but the Bible says they try to put Brother Joseph in a bad light, in a bad situation. But when you got the light on you, ain't no darkness can come your way. You know that you know that you know that you're a child of God, and nobody can trouble you. Nobody can surround you with anything except the Spirit of God. And you must understand and know, first of all, that God will protect you. The Bible says that it seemed as though all had fallen apart for Joseph. Yes, you'll take a moment and examine the facts and look at the facts and clear your own mind and your own thoughts. How can a brother do me like that? How can a brother sell me out? How can a brother? The enemy gonna come. When he come to you, he coming to hurt. He ain't worried about trying to scratch you, elbow. He come to take you out. But when you already been out, he can't take you out. When you already been down to the lowest, he can't mess with you. When you've already know that you know that you know that you know. I've already been through something. You just don't know my story. You see it, but you really don't know my story. If you really knew my story, you're going to try somebody else. You wouldn't bother me. But since you don't know my story, you really knew my story. You blessed me instead of cursing me. I better say, when you've been down, you ain't worried about going back down. And we already been down one time. It's all right to go back and see how it's doing. Because all I know is I came up the last time. I'm coming back up this time. Because God give me grace and mercy. God give me favor to be all right. Oh, I wish somebody could get this message this morning. Because when the Lord is with you, no devil in hell, okay? You don't have to worry about anything except look and live. Get what you've been through with. Don't care how long the devil see. He can't stay all night. He got to go sooner or later. He got to get up out of here. And you got to live and let go and let God. Fact is that he was sold to Potiphar. Do I have anybody? Potiphar's called the captain of the guard, Genesis 37 and 36. The Bible says his position seemed to have been that of a chief. He was like the head of Pharaoh's secret police. He was responsible for protecting his boss and for dealing with those who dared to attack Pharaoh, Potiphar, by virtue of their position. But let me tell you, God's on the position as well. See, when God is over, I don't care how high your position is, Trump, God is still there. God will still come where you are. God will still come and crash your body. That's why you got to get bold in your spirit, man. You got to get so bold in your spirit, man. I'm not talking about you going to cause problems, but I'm talking about you taking a stand on Jesus Christ and wait on the Lord. Anybody ever been waiting? Is there anybody waiting this morning on a promise from the Lord? You can't just wait, but you got to work while you're waiting. Because this time the Lord is coming through with your name on it. The Lord is coming to bless you. Stop looking at where you've been and think the Lord don't know you. Stop looking at you've been crucified here, crucified there. Tell the Lord thank you for that, because you're still here. Yeah. Yeah. Know you've been through some stuff.
Yes, sir.
Know you've been talked about.
Yes.
You know, I love being talked about because it reminds me that I'm doing something. Right or wrong, I'm doing something that got your attention. So I love to be talked about. It's all right. Because when you're talking about me, you're talking about my Father. Because I represent my Father. Which are in heaven. It's heaven above. I represent him. You ought to be representing him. Don't get upset when the angel and the sun going. Don't worry about it. They ain't got nothing else to do. If they had anything else positive to do, they would talk about you. Don't get broken and crushed because somebody called your name. You ought to be happy when they're thinking about you. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus, all he brought me out of, all I can do is shout hallelujah and praise the holy name. Because all I know is the Lord promised me that he'll be right there. The Lord promised me and he'll take me through. And all I'm ready to know is to come through with the Lord. You ought to be ready to come through with the Lord. Tell the Lord, thank him.
Thank you, Lord.
By virtue, God's promise is your benefit. God's promise is your moment. You ought to be able to feel the power of God. The little fellas used to sing a song, can you feel God moving? You ought to be able to feel it moving sometime. You ought to know that you know that you know. That this is not just a natural effect, but this is the power of God. See, the power of God is God's presence. See, I don't know about you. You can't get angry when you're going through. When you're going through, you have to tell the Lord thank you. And hold on and see what the end shall be. Do I have anybody that knows how to hold on? Just to see what the end shall be. See, the word of God, the Bible says, the dreams God gave Joseph in the 39th chapter of Genesis was not off track. They was being fulfilled in God's time, in God's way, in God's style. Now, I'm sure that those dreams, substance, that suited Joseph during the dark days of his survivorship. And you and I have the same protection that Joseph enjoyed. See, one of the things, Brother Sister Connie, Joseph enjoyed bitter moments. Joseph enjoyed the attacks. He enjoyed when the enemy pushed him to. Because Joseph was an upright man. He knew that he was in God's presence. And when you find yourself in God's presence, and attacks from the enemy come to your house, you better get ready to be elevated. Don't complain because you're going through. But get ready to be elevated. Is there anybody ready to be elevated? Because when the enemy try you, tell them about your God. Don't complain that you didn't say it. Don't complain about you didn't do it. One thing about right. Right or take care of yourself. In the presence of God. Can I give a hallelujah? Well, don't let you know that you are a child of God. See, people of God, we have God's promise that all things work together for whom our good. And you say it to the back choir. We have God's promise that things work together for our good. Life, what happens in life, have you shaking your head? Doesn't make sense. Doesn't change the fact that God is in control of everything that happens to us. Obedience to the Lord may lead us into the eye of a terrible storm. This proved truth in Joseph's life. This was also true in the Lord Jesus Christ's life. As we look at this message, God's purpose in our trials and in our life is not to harm us, but to develop us. We can trust him to protect us and grow us amidst the hardships of life. We all know that our God is in control. God gave you a vision, you know God gave it to you. Why are you thinking about failure if God gave it to you? God gives you an objective for your future. You better get working on it. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It even doesn't matter if you feel like you repeat yourself. Get to it and do what God will have you to do. One thing for sure, Brother Good, God prospered Brother Man here. The Bible says when Joseph arrived in Egypt, he no longer had a coat of many colors, but he had a lost coat, but his character was very much intact. I just want to remind you, the answer is in your character. The answer is not in your pocket or your wallet. So even if you get growth and you still got the character, you can make it and be all right.
is the captain only loyalty you have. To the Lord that we serve. I come and every reminder today, your word gonna be something. It can say you don't do what you wanna do. It can say you're going, you wanna go. You said the Lord has gifted you. If you wanna act like you gotta give the Lord. You said the Lord sent you there. Well, you wanna act like you become part of it. You wanna become committed to what God has allowed you to go to. Because without the Lord in your life, that would be no greater life for you. God will prosper you right where you are. When Joseph let that coat go, the Bible says he lost nothing, that it made him a great man. Now Joseph's greatness did not come from the clothes on his body. In other words, I don't care how well you dress, it won't bring no anointing out. I don't care how powerful you look, it won't change your anointing. The only thing that's going to keep your anointing is the gift of God in you, which is your character for the Lord Jesus Christ. But the Bible says, Brother Joseph was still a man of character and integrity. Well, I'll be on your left side. There's a lot of people on your right side. And when you know that your word is intact, the Lord will come and see about you. The Lord will come and promote you. The Lord will keep you delivered in time and on time. When the Lord is with you. No worries about nothing. All of us ought to have a testimony of what the Lord brought me from. We need people of character in the church. Some people are different depending on where and where you meet them. You meet them at church, they are one person. You meet them in town, they are something else. You meet them all across town, you're saying, who is this? In other words, your intelligence and your character ought to be the same. Ought to be the same on the corner of every street you go because of the gift of God on the inside. As we look at this word, regardless of where you go, you ought to have the same testimony. No, when you dressed up or not, you should have the same testimony.
Yes, sir.
The Bible said when Joseph arrived in Egypt, he could have taken several different paths of life. He could have adopted the ways and customs of the new land. He could have abandoned his God and embraced the mental part of non-religion, but Joseph just stayed the course. You see, you may have been purchased by Potiphar, but Joseph belonged to God. He had already made up his mind how things would be in his life. And baby, man, when you made up your mind in life that you're gonna serve God, nobody can change that. I don't care how overwhelming you may get, but the power of God will still be with you. The power of the anointing will still flash in your mind. The power of God will still keep you and keep your mind stayed on the Lord. I don't know about you, but it makes no difference to Joseph, but it was his father's house. It appeared to possess him as a slave trader of the house of his master. The Bible says Joseph had purpose in his heart that he was always going to do the right thing. And that he would just have did this or did that. Joseph was a man of integrity regardless of his situation. See, by you going through life and
and your fumbles in life can cause you to drop the ball, it shouldn't change your integrity. Shouldn't change. Bad marriages shouldn't change your integrity. Bad relationships shouldn't change your integrity. Bad jobs shouldn't change your integrity. You should still be that person that God has already drawn you out to be. Do I have any witnesses? Nothing in life should change your relationship with God Almighty. Somebody else said, thank you, Holy Spirit. This particular text, prosperous man, tells us that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Everything that Joseph touched, it was blessed. It was blessed because of his intentions. If your intentions are in line, then God is going to put you in front of the right helpers. If your intentions, somebody please get that. If your intentions have been discovered by the power of God, then God will put the right person in place for you. The world may not like it, but you've been completed with your assignment. Doesn't matter what you've been through with, doesn't matter where you've been through, doesn't matter how ugly you've been, God will give you the blessings that you deserve to complete your journey. Do I have anybody here? Stop looking at what you've been through. Stop looking at how they talked about you. Stop looking at what you've done yourself. And you remember God turned you around, put clapping in your head, stepping in your feet, gave you joy, unspeakable joy. And all you got is the Holy Ghost. Don't let nobody use your past to take that from you. Nobody. Nobody. No, you keep that prosperous mind. Keep God's blessings in front of you. Continue to think on how you're going to continue to be blessed by the Lord's anointing. How you're going to live. And God will keep you promoted in the eyes of the devil. I can't hear you. God will keep you promoted in the eyes of the enemy. And he will carry you through, bless you like never before. Gotta do it. Because you got a made up mind. I'm gonna do the will of God this time. Doesn't matter how far I got to go, all I know is God is gonna see me through. The Bible says, and finally we got to get out of here. We got a few to go to. Potiphar saw that the hand of God was upon the life of Joseph. He knew that there was something special about this Hebrew slave. As he watched Joseph work, the Bible says, as he saw the results of his work that Potiphar had, that everything Joseph touched turned to gold. You want to look at your hand, turn to gold, baby. Yeah. Oh, you ought to want that spirit on your turn to go. You ought to want that spirit on you. Huh? No matter what you've been through, you ought to still want it. Uh-huh. But Father promoted Joseph and made him, the Bible says, made him the overseer of the entire household. Uh-huh. Joseph was in control of everything that happened in Potiphar's home and even in his business entrance. Uh-huh. Potiphar learned that he could trust Joseph. Oh, listen to that. Can you be trusted? Uh-huh. Do you know if you can be trusted? Uh-huh. So when you know the Lord can trust you, uh-huh. Mother, he gonna make everything A-OK. Uh-huh. Listen, I don't care what you're going through and whatever it is, God's gonna be there for you. I don't care what it is, God's gonna be there for you. I don't care who's against you, God's gonna be there for you. I don't care what they say, God's gonna be there for you. I don't care what they name they call you, God's gonna be there for you. The power of the Holy Ghost. if you've never experienced the power of the Holy Ghost, the anointing of God, you got a ways to go. Because see, the anointing of God turned the enemy out. Y'all just said, I said, the anointing of the Holy Ghost, it checked the enemy. They said, I said, oh, no, you can't go with that. That belongs to me. You can't touch that. That belongs to me. Now, you can't see that. I've already seen that. But when you know that to know, that to know, that to know, God has rediscovered you, redesigned you, put you in the presence of his own, put you in the presence of his anointing. Everything is going to work out. You don't have to worry about nothing. You don't have to worry about nothing. You don't even have to talk about nothing. All you got to do is stay in place. The world don't understand, stay in place. The world don't can't see, stay in place. You learn how to stay in place with the Lord. It'll be like your favorite ice cream cone. All you got to do is turn the corner and have an ice cream shop. And the Lord will continue to bless you just like that. But Joseph knew that he had favor on his life. Because it was easy for Joseph to live a life from somewhere, someone else. But he stayed the course. I can't hear you. He stayed the course and he waited on the Lord. And I challenge you, when you can understand how to wait on the Lord, the Lord will give you your strength. The Lord will give you peace and peace of mind. The Lord will bring you out. The Lord will deliver you. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will take care of every need in your life. I don't care if the boss man don't want to do right. The Lord will make it do right. The Lord will make it bless you. The Lord will make it give you yourself. I don't know about you, but I'm standing in position waiting on the Lord. If you know that you're standing in position waiting on the Lord, you cannot lose. The only thing you can lose is time. And whatever time it takes, I'm going to wait on the Lord. Because I believe this is my season. I said, I believe this is my season. I believe I hear the knocking on the door. Brother Joseph knew that this was his season. This was his time to be elevated. Come on here, clap those hands. Clap them. You got to know that you know that I am a child of God. And it becomes a rush situation for you to hurry to do what the Lord will have you to do. Don't just go to church. Get something from church in you. I said, get something from church in you, and the Lord will see you through. And the Lord will. I said, the Lord will. He will make everything okay. You heard this message. You said, well, preacher, I'm glad you reminded me that the Lord is with me. And I believe the Lord is with me. And I want a connection. You might be saved and unchurched. You may be unsaved and no church. You might be unsaved and churched. I invite you to come, man, woman, boy, or girl, and connect with his presence. You want to be sick and tired of being sick and tired. You want to be ready now to go for what you know. As we stand all over this building, Come to Jesus, just now, come to Jesus, just now. come to Jesus. Just now, whatever you want to come, come. Man, woman, boy, or girl, come on. Come to Jesus. Just now, just now, just now, come to Jesus, just now. Let us join hands and go to prayer. Let us also remember our sister Queen and her Uncle Pig's death. Amen. It's your uncle, isn't it? Let us remember her family as they go through their moment of bereavement as well. All of the other bereaved situations that the Lord will protect and the Lord will take care and deliver and make everything all right. When's this funeral?
Tuesday at 1 o'clock.
Tuesday at 1 p.m.
At St. Mark's
Baptist. St. Mark's Baptist Church down Bluff Road. I think that is Bluff
Gaston.
Road. In Gaston. Mm-hmm. 1 p.m. Amen. Those that can't support her there, let's support her. They've got 5 funerals too, I believe. I will be in Gaston. Amen. I'll be all over the place. But let us keep them in prayer.
Yes.
Show them some love. Amen. And everything will be all right. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Any other bereavements that I've missed? Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you now for who you are in our life. We thank you, God, for how you are in a place with us, God. We thank you for how you keep us, God.
Thank you, God.
God, how you keep our mind regulated, God. We thank you for your anointing, God. We thank you for the presence of Jesus, God. We thank you for being saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. God, we thank you now, God, to know that this too shall pass and everything shall be all right. God, we thank you, God, to know that everything is all right now. And Father God, we plead the blood against anything that's not like you. Oh God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, it is so. Amen. Amen. And amen.
Amen.
I want to clap those hands. It's often time to bring in all the tithes and offer it to the storehouse. See if that will be meat.